Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2. Let me start off by saying I apologize for the last few days. You might have noticed there was a lack of content in the previous few days. That's because I just moved to a new house. And as you might as well hear already, I might have a bit of trouble while setting up my new setup. And that might cause you to hear a bit of an echo maybe. I'm gonna try and fix that in the later episodes, but this is actually the first time I record in my new home. So that is very nice. So today we're gonna go do a very important mission on the bridge, because we don't have any other choice right now. So
Commander, our current
right on the map
is here, just outside Resistance headquarters. When we're not on the move, this will serve as our home and our source of supplies. The Councilman has tracked the alien black site to this region. Unfortunately, we don't have its exact coordinates yet. If we're going to have any chance of finding this facility, we'll need to make contact with the local resistance cell nearby. Tigan has a theory about how we might reach out to them without getting the alien's attention, but we'll need to give him time to conduct his research. We shouldn't wait too long on that, Commander. We have to start making contact with other regions soon if we're going to build a global resistance and take on Advent.
New objective added.
So, we need to make contact with the local resistance in the Blackside region indicated over there on the left in order to gain access to the Advent facility. The aliens are up to something, well, not much good, and we need to find out what that is. So we need to research resistance communications, fly to the Blackside region, and make contact with the resistance
like
over there.
Looks like you won't have time for that just yet, though. Remote reconnaissance may have found something not far from our current position.
But as Bradford just indicates, we have something else on the map as well. We have a surface depot. And it takes 5 days to investigate these kinds of things, and we always get something in return. So let's go investigate. And that actually means that our base moves over there, and we can start scanning that location, as we will do right now, I think.
Commander, while we're waiting for new missions or the completion of our research, we can pass time by scanning at sites like this one. On your order, we'll start our scans of the surrounding area.
So that's something we can do to pass the time, but before we do that, I'm gonna take a quick look around. I'm gonna quickly check up on the troops just to see how they're doing. So we still have everybody available. We still have 3 rookies we need to level up as well. Next up is going to be Vryar. We're going to take him on the next mission. Geralt is still seriously wounded, still out for 7 days, so we're not going to have access to a grenadier just yet, which might be a problem, because we don't have any rangers either, so we're still stuck with a specialist or a sharpshooter. But hey, that will be for when we get our next mission. I think research, yeah, we still have to wait 3 days. And then we have engineering, we don't have anything there as well. So, let's go back to the bridge and let's start scanning that service depot. And there we go, let's get that rolling. 3 days have passed and that should finish our research.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do.
Thank you, Dr. Tigan. So modular weapons research complete, and now we can assign weapon upgrades to the squad's weapons. So let's first assign some new research. So now we can add mods to any weapon we have. There we go. And now we have a bit more choices to make. So we could go for magnetic weapons, which is the next tier of weaponry we can unlock. So that would upgrade all our ballistic weapons into magnetic weapons, as shown over here. We could also go for hybrid materials, which might not be that bad. You know what, I am going to go for hybrid materials. So the Advent bodies we've recovered so far are shielded by a fascinating combination of materials, some more common than others. By studying the underlying alien technology, our research could lead to vast improvements to our own equipment. There we go. 3 days. Yeah, thank you, Dr. Tigan. So that's something he always says. So let's get back to the map and continue scanning those remaining 2 days, hopefully getting ourselves a bit of supplies, because we could be using those. There
we
go.
Strategic resource located.
So we get 51 supplies from the shell of a bombed-out service depot for aircraft is all that remains in this area. But some excavation gave us some more supplies. There we go. There is also another place where we can go to spend our time, and that is the Resistance HQ, the place where we started out as. So as you can see on the map, we have the new Arctic available. That's the region we started in. We can make contact with West Asia over here. And that's apparently it. It's pretty limited as a starting area, because it's completely random which area of the map you get, which can be all around the globe. Next up, we need to go to West Asia, but we can't do that just yet until we researched Resistance Communications. So let's go back to Resistance HQ.
Sector 1, the Arctic.
There we go. And there's a few things we can do in the HQ. We can actually buy, or maybe that's going to be available later on probably. So let's just gain intel. There we go, alien debris cleared. We get 28 supplies for the room that's been cleared out from alien debris. And now we can place something in this slot. One of the more interesting things here is, in my mind at least, well, we have two very interesting things. We have the Advanced Warfare Center, which we can use to improve the recovery rate of our wounded soldiers. And it also increases the chance that we get an extra ability whenever a soldier is promoted. So the sooner we get this, the more chances we get on for extra abilities. So that's actually something really good we can have. It does take 21 days to build though. And therefore it might be more interesting to go for the Guerrilla Tactics School first, which will allow us to actually increase the number of soldiers we can take on a single mission, because we can upgrade that to 5 and eventually to 6, depending on the ranks of our highest ranking soldier. But there we go, Guerrilla Tactics School it is.
We'll start work on the new facility right away, Commander. I'll send word when it's up and running.
There we go, thank you, Shen. And Maria Kuznetsova, our engineer, will be on that. So in apparently 7 days. That's probably halved because of the engineer, right? Yeah, it probably is. So let's get back to the bridge and continue gaining intel from the Resistance HQ. So intel is another, well, valuable substance we need. It's not really a substance, of course, but we can spend that later on in the game as another sort of currency. But let us gain some more intel.
Outcome of this research can
only and hybrid materials has also been completed. So that should unlock plated, the nanoscale vest, which is an item we can give to one of our soldiers to boost their armor. And we also have the research for the plated armor, which is a boost in our general armor plating. So there we go, light armor underlay derived from Advent armor. This vest can be worn with all XCOM armors to increase a soldier's health. We can't do that just yet because we need the alloys. We don't have any alloys, we don't have any Illyrium, so we can't do any of that. Advent data pads, I think if you research those completely, we get some intel out of that, but we don't need intel just yet. But we're gonna go for Resistance Communications first, because that's a more pressing matter. There we go.
Number of valuable applications.
Let's go back to the bridge.
From this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
Thank you, Tigan. So let's gain more intel. And there we go. Now we got
Although
a bit.
We have allies scattered in cities throughout the globe who are willing to share their knowledge of Advent's operations. The aliens are actively pursuing them. It will be up to you to ensure the safety of our operatives, Commander.
There
Good
we go.
Luck.
So now we got a special resistance mission. And that in this mission we're gonna have to rescue a VIP from an Advent vehicle. If we are successful in here, we're gonna get another scientist. Scientists improve the rate at which research is completed. And we also get 82 intel, which is very nice indeed. So let's launch the mission. Yeah, there we go. Let's see, we're not gonna go with this squad. Mainly because, well, we won't be able to do this with two specialists and two sharpshooters. So I am gonna remove a trophy nut. We could use actually two specialists, that's actually not bad. And as promised, I am gonna use Vryar's character, Ulrich Edel, to the squad, so welcome. And I think this is the squad we're gonna go out with. So we have the shock with Benito, we have the well, we just have the hacking ability with Hugh, and we have Cedric's impeccable sniping ability. And then I'm really curious what Vryar is going to pan out as, at which class he's going to be. So without further ado, let's launch our mission and get this done. Let's rescue this VIP.
Deployed.
Just at the very north of the map.
Menace, ready to deploy.
Ready, and if you're ready, we are too.
Recon has been keeping an eye on an Advent transport convoy moving through this area. As it turns out, a VIP of some importance to the Resistance is being held in one of their trucks. They've asked us to move in and handle the rescue operation. We'll have to eliminate any hostile forces nearby and secure the area, then get the VIP to safety.
There we go, Advent Central Zone in Novgorod. Operation Dawn Tower. I really like the operation names. Because they're, as most of the game is, they're completely randomized. So every time you get a mission, the name is completely randomized from a huge list of words, actually. I think you can actually, in the PC version, you can actually check out the word list. So there we go, launch mission. Just as before, I think with rescue missions, we still start in concealment because the aliens don't know what we're about to do. Well, attempt to do. So there we go.
Menace,
I think we start
five,
in concealment.
We have a confirmed location for the
I hope.
VIP. Move to rendezvous. Eliminate all hostile contacts.
Yeah, there we go. Concealed. I'm going to quickly show this off. So this is the vehicle we need to open and get the VIP out of. We have 12 turns in this rescue mission. And then we need to extract at a fixed point right here. We can't use our extraction zone as we sometimes could before. We need to go extract on this roof, which might actually be... No, those are pipes, so we're probably going to get right up there if we need to. So, still in concealment, so time is of the essence. We're going to move quickly through the map. I think I'm going to go through here. If we can, I would try and get on top of the roof, actually. So yeah, that's not bad. Hopefully I don't trigger anything by going up here. Otherwise we're onto a great start. So we need to go over here. Our technician. Doesn't seem like he sees something. Yeah, so a sectoid and a trooper. Not too bad. We might as well take advantage of that and spread our troops out a bit. Cedric has squad side, so I'm gonna put him right over here.
Closing on target position 9.
Let's put Hugh up here next to Benito as well. Hopefully he doesn't see anybody on the right there. I don't think he should. No, okay, I can switch, so no trouble over there. So let's put Vryar a bit closer as well. Maybe he can do something with his grenade. And let's put you, Cedric, on Overwatch with your pistol. There we go. Let's see how they move. Okay, so we have two more troopers entering the area. We know they're there. They're probably gonna... Yeah, they're gonna vanish behind the car. Okay, so now we know those guys are there as well. We do have to be careful with explosives here, because of course the truck over there is where the VIP is in. So... Another thing that's very interesting is the hacking ability of the specialists. Doesn't actually break concealment until you actually hack and fail to hack, if I'm not mistaken. Otherwise, I'm gonna be a huge fool, but yeah, I think we can... Looking is harmless. So, we could get a small cache of alien alloys. So we might do that at the end of the mission. I'm not gonna do that right now, because we would get reinforcements if we fail the hack, so no. Let's not do that. So let's recall our drone. And let's see what else we can do. So that doesn't take a turn, by the way. Just checking doesn't take a turn. So let's... I wonder where those... Okay, so those guys just stayed over there. That is interesting. Can we get higher up? We can. Let's put Benito high up.
Okay.
Soldiers that are higher up also get a bit of an aim bonus when they are higher up. So even Vryar here will get a bit of an aim bonus regarding those aliens down there. Don't want to waste too much time setting this up though. I'm going to put them right over here. Let Hugh sit right next to him. Buddies right next to each other. And I could actually start shooting right now, but I think I'm just gonna do one more round of Overwatches before we actually move further. I'm gonna put Cedric, I'm gonna leave him behind here, because now we can Overwatch with his sniper rifle, and everybody else on Overwatch as well. Unless these guys come very close, they shouldn't be a problem. I would prefer if these guys back off a bit. I'm wondering, can I get... how high can I get up here? Could go over here, but first gonna check out. Let's put you over here as well. If I put him here, do you have sight on anybody? You might have sight on the soldiers, but I'm just gonna...
shoot.
Set this up a bit. Put Friar over here in the corner.
Don't lose, kids.
And hopefully we lose sight. We don't lose sight completely. Which actually sucks a bit. Because right now, if he starts shooting at those two, the two over there will trigger as well. If I move Friar up a bit, let's put him over here in the corner, just out of sight so nobody can shoot him. Do we lose sight of... we don't. Okay. I think I'm gonna have to do one more round of Overwatches. I'm gonna put him right next to the other guys. No, I can't. So I'm gonna just put him right here in cover. Maybe full cover. Over here might not be bad. Hopefully I'm not gonna trigger anything else over here. I do have enough turns, so let's just put him over here behind the truck. There we go. Don't trigger anything else, and then let's just put everybody else on Overwatch and wait it out a bit. So hopefully those guys just now disappear. Yeah, okay, that's what I want. That's perfectly what I want. So now I can focus completely on the sectoid and the trooper over there. So let's start this off with... who am I going to start this off with? Maybe start off with a sniper shot now that they're wide in the open. Might as well start this off with a sniper shot. I could take out the trooper immediately. The sectoid is a priority. He has the most health points as well. So let's just try this out. Cedric, take him out. Take him out. Ooh, 7 damage. That's almost down, I think. I think he has 8 health. So he has 1 left. Yeah, that's great. Okay. So spotted is not bad. They're gonna have to choose whether to stay in cover for the guys up top or not. So, ooh. That's actually pretty smart. But we know we can take out the sectoid with Benito's shock ability. So let's use... I'm gonna put Humongous a bit closer. He can still see everybody. 72% on the trooper, so that's not bad actually. So let's go with that first. Ooh, there are 3 damage. That's too bad. Okay, so that means Vryar is gonna have to finish this guy off. 70% shot. Are you gonna go for your promotion immediately with your first shot? Here we go. There we go. Very nicely done. First trooper taken out. Is that a promotion? Yeah, there we go. Promotion earned. So he's gonna level up. Well, get his class assigned in the next... after this mission is done. So let's go with the combat protocol we unlocked in the previous mission, and let's just kill this sectoid outright. So no percentages on this one. This is guaranteed 2 damage. There we go.
Guarda un po'.
And the drone shocks him a bit. There we go. Ooh, and loot. So now we need to take care of that as well. Are those troopers gonna come into view again? Because they're not triggered yet.
Be advised, hostile interceptors are inbound on your current position.
Okay.
Firebrand has a limited window to provide extraction.
So that's just warning us about the fact that we do not have that many turns left. I'm gonna take care not to immediately trigger anything. I probably am going to trigger them, because they were pretty close. And so let's put Benito over here. There we go. Are they there? No, okay. So they're probably pretty much out of sight. Let's put Cedric over here in full cover. He might trigger something, he might not. I don't think, because I could switch. So Let's put everybody back down, because we're gonna have to move here. I'm not gonna move Benito, I'm just gonna move Ryer up a bit. Although I might, if I'm gonna look at the other side of the truck, they're probably gonna come crawling out of the woodworks. So let's put him right over here. It should not trigger anything. I don't see anything. Okay, never mind. I was wrong on that one. So two troopers. We still have two actions left. And I'm saying action because Hugh apparently doesn't see those guys. It's too far for a grenade, and Benito doesn't have a grenade. So I'm gonna just put him back here in the corner.
Roger.
Don't think we have much other choice. Just protect him a bit. And then let's put Humongous on Overwatch. So we do have Ryer in the open there. Which could be bad. Yeah, there we go. So Hugh's Overwatch shot might hit. It looks like a hit. Yeah, there we go. Trooper down. Well done, Hugh. Took that like a champ. Okay, so now he has a nice shot at... He took a shot at Hugh. He was mad at him. That was interesting. Okay. But now he's open to a flank shot, so... I mean, Freya, you're closest. Let's just do that. I'm gonna check if I can get the loot. I could get it with Cedric over here. Just put him over here. But let's first put Vryer a bit closer. Hopefully he doesn't trigger anything else. He might... Yeah, there we go. Okay. That's not bad. I think I might have to forgo the loot we just found. Let's see. 82% shot, and it's a flank shot. Let's see what Cedric can do, actually, with a sniper rifle. He has a shot at the trooper, and a very, very... low percentage shot at the sectoid. This Vryer shot at the sectoid is actually not that much better. But you could throw a grenade, opening up everything for... that would be risky. Let's see, I'm gonna put Hugh over here.
Okay.
If he's over there, he has a flank shot on the trooper as well. His other shots are bad as well, but... 72%. This could work, actually. So, Hugh, here we go. That was disappointing. Because the other thing I could do is actually open up the cover that the sectoid is hiding behind. Just blow everything up. But I don't think I can do that with anybody here. Let's just try and take out the trooper from here. If Cedric can do it, then we can take Vryer away from the sector. Yeah, there we go. Thank you, Cedric. Nice shot. So now we can put Vryer in a bit of a better position. It's too bad we can't get the loot, but better to lose some loot than actually lose one of our soldiers. So let's put him right over here in full cover, and he's probably out of sight of everybody, so they shouldn't know where he is. There we go. And then we have... this is actually another interesting one. Could put him over here. Let's see what the sidelines are over here. Do you see anything? No. So if we put you on Overwatch, you might actually take a shot at anybody who passes. Ooh. Is that... Okay, no. It's gonna resurrect someone? Yeah, okay, there we go. That is actually pretty, pretty good. That's good. Reanimated. That's not bad. That soldier is a bit disconcerting. He just goes on Overwatch. Okay. Loot expired. That's not bad. So now we have apparently only sight on the Psy zombie, who's behind the car. You can see the sectoid from here, but not... How do you not see the guy over there in the corner? So now we have a trooper who's on Overwatch, so we need to be careful here. We could take a shot at... Oh, come on. Can't you see that fucking trooper over there? Apparently you can't. I think Vryar is gonna have to save the day here. Okay, so let's try Vryar's grenade. Let's put it right... I don't think this is a roof where we need to go up, right? Okay, so no. That's the roof over there. We only have 6 turns left, by the way. So we're gonna have to book it after this. So let's blow up the sectoid with Vryar's grenade. That should take away his cover. And maybe even the trooper's cover, who knows? So there we go, at least 3 damage, maybe 4? Ooh, 3 damage, okay. So he does lose his cover, which is great. So now we have a pretty nice shot from here. But I think I'm gonna use Hugh's grenade as well to blow up the trooper. Might actually kill him, which would be amazing if he does. But we haven't seen any 4 damage grenades just yet. And we haven't still. So, there we go. 2 unflanked enemies. Well, uncovered enemies. So, that also removes the overwatch that the... Oh god, you still can't see that trooper, apparently. That also removes the overwatch of the trooper, which allows us to come closer with Benito. So, let's take a sniper shot at the sectoid, which should kill it, hopefully. Come on, Cedric, come on. Oh, in the face, that was a critical. That was nice, that was very, very nice. Okay, so now it's all up to... yeah, there goes the zombie because the sectoid died. And now we can use Benito to get a bit closer and take a shot at the trooper over there. Let's put you right over there behind the screens. And shoot. 73%. Come on, here we go. Kill him. Kill him. Ooh, yeah, 5 damage. That was a really undignified position in the fire right there. That was a bit... Okay, so with that done, we have 5 turns left to get the VIP and get everybody out of there. So that means Cedric as well. So we're gonna have to book it with Cedric over here. So the only one who can open the truck immediately is Vryar right now. So let's see. I'm gonna have to scout with him then. So let's put him over here first, so we can check behind the truck. Because we killed 6 aliens already, so that shouldn't be too much of a problem anymore. Still don't want to take too much of a risk. So now we can pretty much determine that there's nobody... You know what, let's put you up a bit first as well, so we can clear that side of the truck as well. Yeah, okay. So let's use Vryar to open the doors here. Let's put you right over there. There we go, didn't trigger anything because I don't think there are any aliens anymore. And then we need to hack. Oh, maybe we can actually hack with somebody else, with one of the specialists, because there are bonuses when you actually hack something like that. Because Hugh is a hacker as well, if I'm not mistaken. Can you actually hack the door from over here on the corner? I'm actually wondering. Okay, thank you. There we go.
Give it to treat.
Okay, let's turn the camera around a bit. Can we hack the door? We can. So let's hack the door open. And that should get us the VIP immediately. What are the effects? A small cache of supplies for 76% chance, or a large cache of supplies? 36 is a bit steep. So we're gonna go for the small cache. Ooh, just about. Yeah, there we go. Nice hack. You? A very nice hack from Humongous. There we go, opening the door. Okay, there we have the VIP. Yes, we're gonna go to the evacuation point.
VIP is in tow. Proceed to the extraction point.
So now I'm gonna do... Wanna put Cedric over here on the as far as possible, just so he can get on top of the roof. But his sniper rifle is empty. So we might as well reload him as well. And let's see what happens now. So yeah, there we go. Ooh. Reinforcements on the roof right next to the extraction point.
Menace 1-5, we're picking up an enemy transport inbound on your current position.
So now we have 3 turns left.
High speed approach. Your window for extraction is closing.
I'm wondering, probably the only one who can't make it is Cedric. I have to be careful here, so let's put him right over there. We're just gonna book it towards the extraction point. Because we can't really put anybody safer here, so let's put Breyer over there, so Ulrich over there. Let's put you, Benito, over there, our technician over there. I think I am going to evacuate the VIP immediately, because we can't do anything with the VIP other than that. Hugh, I think... I have to be careful not to leave anyone behind. Because Hugh is almost out of ammo as well, but... could actually put Hugh over here and then reload him. You know what, I'm not going to take the risk. Let's just put everybody as close as possible to the extraction point.
J'y suis déjà.
There we go, let's evacuate you. There we go, VIP gone, and then we're going to have to see what we get for reinforcements. So there are the aliens. This is going to be tense. So three troopers, it looks like. There went my voice. Three troopers. Three troopers it is. I don't think I'm going to take the risk. Are they going to go in Overwatch or are they going to stay? Okay, so they are going to cluster out. They don't go into Overwatch. For this type of mission, we don't really need to kill every alien. I don't see the point of it right now either. So just going to put everybody into the evacuation zone and work our way gone from here, because we only have two turns left to evacuate everybody. So let's put everybody in the safe zone.
Mi avvicino alle coordinate.
So we are right in the center, Mr. Edel. And then we can evacuate everybody. Hopefully I don't mispress anything, because that would be bad. So let's evacuate you. Evacuate Benito. Evacuate Cedric. And evacuate you. There we go. Well done. Great work, guys. We got the VIP, and that's what we came here for. Done.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Flawless. No wounded soldiers and no killed soldiers either. So we took 11 out of our 12 turns we got, but we got the VIP out safely. So there we go. Average damage per attack. Not that bad, but we got a new record on the successful shot percentage. Hugh clearly did the most work here. He made the most attacks and he was under fire the most. And Cedric, as our sniper, of course, dealt the most damage here. And Ulrich was the fastest of the bunch. He moved the furthest. He was our scout a bit, so he might actually turn out to be a ranger with that cowboy head and all. So here we go. So back in the Avenger, on the Avenger actually. Bit of a longer mission, and it has been the longest mission we have done so far. We have two promotions. We're first going to check out Ulrich here. So let's check this out. So he is a grenadier, very nice. Okay, so we're going to have to upgrade him really nicely, because grenadiers are really handy, so they can lob grenades a lot further, and they can carry a few more grenades than a normal soldier can. So launch grenade. The grenadier uses a grenade launcher to fire grenades rather than throwing them. Allows for greater range and grenade capacity. So, thanks for that, really nicely. We did need another grenadier. The only thing we're lacking right now is a ranger, a really good ranger. Benito also got his promotion, and I'm wondering... yeah, so we could either go for the revival protocol, allowing us to revive unconscious soldiers, so taken out but not killed, and remove any negative effects as well. Which is good for a healer, but, well, we haven't been building him out as a healer, so we're gonna go for the Haywire Protocol. And now we can target it. Benito can target robotic and mechanical enemies, attempting to hack them and seize control. So we could take over mechanical enemies, robot enemies. We haven't seen any of those yet, but they will come into play really, really soon. So Haywire Protocol it is. We're gonna move him towards the aggressive hacker route, the combat hacker route. There we go. Another sergeant added, I think he Yeah, never mind, he's the first sergeant in the squad. There we go, 6 kills in 3 missions. Same as his buddy Cedric over there. Yeah, very nice. So we got that small cache of supplies, the VIP, and of course I think we got 82 intel as well.
Commander,
there we go.
My expectations were high, and yet you have exceeded them.
Thank you, Counselor.
Thank you for sending additional support staff to assist me, Commander. I will make sure they are put to good use.
So Tygon congratulates us on our new researcher that he can add to his staff, and that reduces our research time by 33%. Which is very nice indeed.
Most of our new recruits have never worked in close quarters like the Avenger. Before the war, we might have had time for training, but now, they're gonna have to pick things up on the fly.
Yeah, indeed, Bradford, because stark contrast to the previous game, this is of course a resistance movement, so these guys are not actually soldiers. Well, not all of them are, anyway. Let's see, so we have Geralt back as well. I kind of forgot that. Before we set out, kind of went with what we got there in the menu, but we can use Geralt again, so we can actually have 2 Grenadiers. He's shaken a bit, so his will is reduced, so he can get mind controlled a bit easier than any of our other soldiers, but if we do a successful mission with him, that actually is removed, and he actually gains a bit of will. So that's really nice, we got another Grenadier, so now we have 2 Sharpshooters, 2 Specialists, and 2 Grenadiers at our disposal. Let's see, do we have anything extra in engineering that we need to check?
Commander?
We do have a bit of extra items here. I'm gonna take a flashbang. Flashbangs are really great for last resorts kind of things, because they reduce the aim of other soldiers, of the enemy soldiers, of course. And that could actually help us out a bit if we need to leave enemies out in the open, that they can take a shot at us. So the nanoscale vest, we can make those as well, but I'm not going to use any of those because they take the slots of the grenades, etc. So I'm not going to use that. Okay,
slim,
that's
but
nice.
I we find a few more recruits who can handle a wrench. I could use the help.
It's actually a nice detail that we have the snow underneath the Avenger right now because we're in the new Arctic. So let's see what we have here. So 4 days until we are done with the research for resistance communications, and 5 days until our guerrilla tactic school is created. So let's go back to the bridge. Let's see what we can find over here. Oh, an abandoned colony. Commander, after our recent success, members of the resistance in New Arctic have brought us reports of activity that we might want to investigate. Let's investigate that. Because we could get a rookie out of that, which is really nice. There we go. I think it takes 6 days to scan for another rookie. So if we're done with that, we should get another soldier, which is actually really cool. Ooh, are we gonna get that? No.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries.
So resistance communications are done. So we can now create the facility resistance comms, and we can research further into the resistance radios, and we can actually try to contact other people. Resistance comms facility increases the number of regions that we can make contact with. Further contacts can be gained by staffing an engineer here once construction is completed. We only have 1 engineer so far, so we can't do that just yet. I think we have something really cool that comes from the Advent Officer autopsy as well, so let's do that first.
The Advent Officers appear to be similar, if not physically the same as the common Advent Trooper in terms of power and agility. However, field reports indicate a more developed mental acuity, as the officers do provide tactical directives to the subordinate Advent forces.
So there's nothing wrong with your screen or something, or with your viewer. There's always a bit of a hitch in those cutscenes on the console version for some reason. Don't know why, but apparently still a bug they haven't fixed yet. So that should only take 2 days, so we're gonna be here back quickly.
Exciting about working on.
Okay, sorry, Tygon, didn't mean to cut you off there.
Word. The new resistance communications network is fully operational. Now we just have to spread the word.
So now we can actually make contact with another region, East Asia. And of course, West Asia, which we knew
now
already for the Blacklight
Blackside facility. We can use our intel resources to make contact with the local resistance cell in this region. Aside from getting us into the Black Site, our access to supplies should improve now that we've expanded our reach.
Yes, indeed. So if we contact other areas, we do open up this area for other missions. That's one of the benefits we get. We also get more supplies each month. As you can see, there's a plus 40 supply bonus if we make contact with West Asia. And then we have this one, gives us 60 supplies extra per month. We do, of course, have to prioritize this one first because the Advent Black site is located right here. But now, since we only have 2 days left on the abandoned colony over here, we're gonna keep scanning over here.
Ooh,
and that's Guerrilla Tactics School, which is really nice. Let's view the facility really quickly. Look at that, a nice gym where our soldiers can improve their skills. The really cool thing about the Guerrilla Tactics School is that we actually can train rookies to immediately gain a class without them actually coming along on a mission before. Let's check out the combat tactics first. So these are upgrades to our general way of working. Of course, the important one is squad size 1, which increases our squad size by 1, allowing us to take 4 soldiers on one mission instead of 4. So we're going to take that one immediately. There we go. So now we don't have supplies enough to take anything else. There are a few interesting ones. So Vulture doubles the loot. It gives us an extra item every time the enemies drop some loot. Then we have Lightning Strike, where we move faster, so we can move further in the first 2 turns while we're in concealment. It's actually pretty expensive for what it does, so I'm not gonna invest in that just yet. Wetwork is a really interesting one. So that just permanently boosts every experience gain from kills by 25%, allowing our soldiers to level up a lot more quickly. Very interesting, that one, but rather costly. And now I have a whole bunch of other ones, which we only unlock those when our soldiers increase in rank. But that's that. But I think I'm gonna put someone here. I think I'm gonna go put Christophe here immediately, and then we can train him to be a ranger, because we're still lacking a ranger. That doesn't cost anything. The room takes care of that by itself. It only costs 5 days. We can't use Christophe in those 5 days. But that's not that bad now, is it? Since we have the engineer available right now, we're going to put her to work immediately and clear the next room of alien debris. There we go. First. Excavate. So now we have more space. Soon, in 5 days again, we're going to have another spot open to get another room there. So let's get back to the bridge. Finish up that scanning though for those rookies, hopefully. Yeah, there we go. So now we got, that is interesting. Did we just get 3 rookies? So we have Manchik Hong. I think that's a randomized character. Then we have Jazz Gypsy, which is one from the character pool. I think one of my co-workers added that one. And Cecil Harambe. Which is also someone from the character pool, I think. Awaiting orders in the armory. So now we have 3 more rookies. Let's look at them in full glory over here. So now we have actually 10 soldiers available, which is really, really nice. 10? No, wait. We have 11 soldiers available, but Christophe is not available because he's in ranger training. So, Cecil Harambe. Let's check him out. Bavarius. Ooh, he's pretty dark. Hunched over a bit, probably referencing the gorilla Harambe. There we go, look at that. So that's him. Then we have Jazz Gypsy, also a very, very black and white kind of fella. Jazz Gypsy probably, yeah. And then we have the generic guy, not from the character pool apparently, Manchik Hong from Korea apparently. That's very nice. We also have weapon upgrades that we never apply to any of our soldiers. Let's check that out. I think we have a scope that we can add to Cedric's sniper rifle. There we go. A nice scope, adding 5% aim permanently to his shots, which could come in handy. What are the... okay, so we can improve our will. I'm not going to do that with him. I'm going to put that on Geralt since his will is reduced. Let's put the PCS chip focus on him. What else do we have? I think we have hair trigger left, right? So we have a bonus action chance. I'm not going to equip that just yet. Okay, so that's that. Fresh blood for the battlefield. And well, with that done, we're gonna head back to the bridge again and keep scanning for another mission. Let's take a look around. So I think we're gonna have to go. Can I make contact? I think that costs us supplies as well, but let's check
after
this
out.
After
we pay the initial intel cost to make
contact, it's intel.
We'll have
okay.
to scan the region for a few days before the local resistance cell comes out of hiding. Once we find them, we'll be up and running in the new region.
Okay, thank you, Bradford, for the information. So we can make contact. It costs intel. We have plenty of intel left, so let's do that.
Setting course for Sector 15.
And then we're heading to West Asia, trying to unlock this area. So now we need to be here and try to make contact for about 4 days.
So far, we've managed to locate a resistance cell operating out of this region. It'll take us some time to scan for their exact position, though.
Okay, 4 days. And we're blocked.
Advents move quietly.
Okay, I know what's coming.
We have you to thank for that.
Our pleasure, Den Mother. Enjoy it while it lasts.
We plan to. Our water purification.
Massive signal coming from the Advent Network Tower. It's global. Sir, I think you want to see this.
Fellow citizens. For 20 years, the Advent Coalition has worked tirelessly to repair the ravages and injustices of the old world. Under our stewardship, our cities prosper, our people flourish, and our world heals.
And yet,
among us, there are still those who would refuse to acknowledge the truth, who are determined to see all that we have achieved.
Multiple radar contacts on approach to Haven Alpha 7.
That must end.
Even as I speak to you today,
you've got incoming on approach.
Your signal's breaking up.
Outlying territories to end this scourge once and for all.
They're right on top of you.
Losing you, Avenger.
Raise them again.
We will ensure your continued safety.
That's another one of the resistance cells. They are gonna get brutally murdered.
With your cooperation, we will overcome these radical elements and usher in another 20 years of peace and prosperity.
They don't stand a chance.
No, they don't.
We should get a squad ready to deploy.
And I think that fifth soldier is gonna come in handy. And that is something we don't really want to mess with. New alien type.
Commander, we have a squad ready to move on the Resistance Haven currently under siege by the aliens. Give the word and we'll move out.
So these are the dreaded retaliation missions. So Advent is not content with us attacking them with guerrilla strikes. They are going to try to destroy one of the resistance cells that we've worked so hard for to create, to build up. And if we fail these missions, we're gonna lose contact with that cell, which is actually very bad for us. They're also very, very difficult. Don't get me wrong, and they come up every now and then. So let's view the retaliation site. So right where we started in the New Arctic, that is completely under attack. Operation Precious Tome. So let's see who we're gonna take with us on this mission.
It's a
really, really difficult
territories.
Mission. Not making any jokes here. These things are really, really hard. So, let's see. We do have a nice squad setup, I think. I think I'm gonna go with the two grenadiers, which is really, really nice. Cedric has a sniper. Yeah, I think we're gonna just take our best squad to this mission. So we're gonna go with Geralt and Vryar, our grenadiers. Cedric, our sniper. And Hugh and Benito are two specialists, but one who has the hacking ability, just in case there are any drones hovering about. Could actually go for another sniper. I am really doubting now. Should I go for two snipers instead of two specialists? Don't think we're gonna get robotic enemies just yet. Yeah, I don't know. The extra range could help on these kinds of maps. But so could, of course, an extra just normal soldier. Huh. Let's just keep it like that and see what happens. If it doesn't, well, so be it. But with that said, I'm gonna take a little break. Next time we're gonna head straight into this retaliation mission. Hopefully you guys will join us right then. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!